Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 6.2, Problem 3. This is Section 6.2, Problem number 3. It says, the probability that Colleen will get brain freeze from drinking her frozen coffee drink too fast is 28%. Use the binomial probability formula, n combination x times p to the x times 1 minus p to the n minus x, to find the probability that Colleen won't get brain freeze at all in the next 3 times that she has a frozen coffee drink. So when I do one of these problems, I like to start off by writing out the formula, n combination x times p to the x power times 1 minus p to the n minus x. And then off to the side, write n equals, x equals, and p equals, and then fill it in. So n is the number of trials. In this problem, n is 3, because it says next 3 times, so 3 trials for the experiment. X is the number of successes. So how many times are we trying to find the probability that Colleen will get brain freeze? Well, it'd be 0, because it says that she won't get brain freeze at all. So it'd be 0 times. So X is 0. And probability of success as a decimal, 28% will be entered into the formula as 0.28. It's important that you put it in as a decimal. So now as we fill these in, n combination x will become 3 combination 0. P to the x will be 0.28 to the 0. Again, x is 0. And then 1 minus p is 1 minus 0.28 to the n minus x power will be 3 minus 0. Now, before I start any significant computation, I like to just clean up the rightmost parentheses, the last parentheses. So the first one will stay 3 combination 0 for another minute. The middle one will stay 0.28 to the 0 power for a minute. But now 1 minus 0.28 can be simplified to 0.72. That's 1 minus 0.28. And the exponent, 3 minus 0, is 3. So now I have 3 sets of parentheses. What I'm going to do is find an answer, a number answer for each set of parentheses. I'll have 3 answers, and I multiply those 3 answers together. So now 3 combination 0, if you remember one of the shortcuts from combinations, anytime the second number is 0, the answer is 1. Now, you may or may not remember that. Let's say you don't remember. So off to the side, you say, okay, 3 combination 0, I'm going to use the combination formula, which is n factorial over x factorial times n minus x in parentheses factorial. And again, the larger number is the n and the smaller number is the x. So to fill this in, the n factorial will be 3 factorial. And in the denominator, the x factorial will be 0 factorial. Inside the parentheses, n minus x will be 3 minus 0 factorial. And the 3 minus 0, I can clean that up to just 3. So 3 factorial on the top, and underneath 0 factorial times 3 factorial. So the 3 factorial on top is 3 times 2 times 1. In the denominator, 0 factorial, you have to remember, anytime you have 0 factorial, the answer is not 0, it's 1. It's just defined to be 1. And then 3 factorial is 3 times 2 times 1. So if you multiply it all out, you get 6 over 6, which reduces to 1. Or you just cancel 3, 2, 1 on the top, 3, 2, 1 on the bottom. You have the same thing over itself, and you do get 1. So I remembered it was going to be 1. But if you don't remember, you waste maybe 20 or 30 seconds. Not the end of the world. Now, the middle set of parentheses is also a special rule for whenever you have anything raised to an exponent of 0. That answer is always 1. You might think that it would be 0, but it's not. Anything to the 0 power is 1. So the middle set of parentheses is also 1. And now the last set of parentheses, 0.72 to the third, will be 0.72 times 0.72 times 0.72. You'll have 3 of them multiplied together. That's something I would want to do with a calculator, and we'll do it very easily. 0.72 times 0.72 times 0.72. And the answer comes out to 0.373248. So now I have to multiply 1 times 1 times 0.373248. Well, of course, the times 1 is easy. The final answer comes out to 0.373248. Now, that's more places after the decimal than you really need. So you can just call it 0.373 if you like, or if you prefer percents, it's slightly more than a 37% probability. So the probability that Colleen will be able to drink her frozen coffee drink three times and not get brain freeze at all is slightly more than a 37% probability.